first I will mention where Prophet Muhammad prophesies in the Bible, then I will go to the Quran. Do you agree with me?
All right, go ahead. Go ahead.
An act.
Can we read it?
But you don't need.
No, no, we need to know what it says.
Okay. An act number three.
Act three.
Acts.
Act three.
Act three. Wait.
Verse 22, 26.
Should I read, madam?
Read it, please.
Acts 2, yeah? 22, right?
22.
Read, madam. You want to read?
No, you read it,
read.
Please.
You men of Israel. Is that what you got?
Yeah, that's yes. What he's told.
You men of Israel.
No, that's Acts. No, you Acts. He said Acts chapter 3.
3 or 2?
3.
Verse
three.
Number 33.
22.
Right.
For Moses said,
yeah.
The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among your own people. You must listen to everything he tells. Anyone who does not listen to him will be completely cut off from among his people. Okay. Indeed, all the prophets from Samuel on, as many as have spoken, have foretold these days. And you are heirs of the prophets and of the covenant God made with your fathers. He said to Abraham, through your offspring, all people on earth will be blessed. When God raised up his servant, he sent him the first to you to bless you by turning each of you from your wicked ways.
Brilliant point. That's your text, sir. Yes. Not ours, your text. Yes.
So let him tell us why this
Bible?
Passage.
You want a Bible? Where
you
is this Bible?
You can rely.
No, just a moment.
Yeah, yeah. You can realize here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to Abraham that all his offspring will be blessed. That means including Ismail, because he is the firstborn of Abraham, the firstborn for Abraham before Ishaq.
Hold on. Before you go further, one minute. It says, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up unto you of your brethren. Who are the brethren?
The brethren. Aren't they brethren between Ismail and Ishaq and Yaqub?
No, she's right. Brethren are the Israelites.
No, talking about Moses.
The children of Israel.
Okay, open another one then.
So wait.
You're not accepting this.
You're not accepting this.
I want us to first, let's examine it. Acts chapter 2, verse 22 to 26. Acts chapter 3,
let me finish it,
verse 22 to 26.
Yeah.
You said,
yeah.
God will raise up
a prophet
among your own people,
yeah.
Moses, among your own people, Israelites. Okay?
12 tribe of Israel, yeah.
And if that prophet, that quotation comes from Deuteronomy chapter 18.
Yeah.
If that prophet doesn't come in the name of Yahweh, he should put to death.
Right.
That's what the Deuteronomy chapter 18 is telling
this?
Us.
May I answer this?
Let me finish.
You're going to answer. Go on, finish.
So,
and then she answers.
Acts chapter 3, verse 22 to 26,
yeah.
Just screams out, Muhammad is false prophet. That's all it does.
All right.
All it does. And it also confirms death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ. Again, proves Islam is false religion. Muhammad is false prophet.
Right.
That's all it does.
Right. Get in, come in now.
Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam in chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, from verse number 39, to verse number 112, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking with the Jew directly that I bestow my grace upon you, I save you from Pharaoh, I take you from Egypt, obey me, obey my prophet, which I put my word in his mouth. This we will read it at Deuteronomy 18:18. A prophet like you, like Moses. And now I would like you to open Isaiah 29 verse 12.
No, wait.
Isaiah
wait.
Number 29, verse 12.
Hold on a minute.
Okay.
You quote a text, and this text that you quote destroy your religion.
Fair enough.
Okay, so...
I accept. Brother, it's all right.
Islamic Dawatim is quite all right.
All right.
The passage they brought up against us
we will read.
To destroy us. Their own religion.
Yeah, but carry on.
It does not only destroy your own religion, it also tells you, Yahya, your eternity is in a bad state.
Don't worry about my eternity.
I don't worry about your eternity.
All right, carry on, Omar.
Because my God cares for your eternity.
My God is real. Right.
So open Isaiah 29:12.
Okay, let me read it. So first we established Isaiah 42 has only thing to do with Muhammad is Muhammad false prophet.
Right.
Acts chapter 3. 22 to 26
right.
has only one thing to do with Muhammad. Muhammad is false prophet.
Prophet again.
Let's see Isaiah 29, verse 12.
We're reading. It's easy.
This is the profession.
Yes. This is more. Islam delivered this one to us. So we will vet him.
Please.
I read Isaiah 29.
I'm going to read the verse and I'm going to explain it to you.
Yeah,
okay?
Yes, go on.
Isaiah 29, verse 12.
Read.
Or if you give a scroll to someone who cannot read and say, read this please, he will answer, I don't know how to read it. So argument comes from Muslims. Correct me if I am wrong, but please give me chance to explain. 610, one day Muhammad is in a cave meditating. Suddenly angel appears to Muhammad. He freaked out what he saw. And angel says to Muhammad, Ikhra, read in the name of Allah. What Muhammad says, he freaks out as well. I can't read and write. There are lots of, so according to Muslims, because it gives us the first account, angel met with Muhammad, therefore Isaiah 29 is the prophecy of Muhammad, correct?
Not correct.
Correct me, please.
What's going on, man?
Let him correct me. The lady's killing you.
I agree. Go on.
I agree.
Go on.
So what did I say was wrong?
It's a lady, man.
What did I say was wrong?
Go on.
What I said, Deuteronomy 18:18, if you read it, you will see that God will send an angel to him and he will put his word in his mouth. The false prophet Muhammad, according to you, he stay among his people 40 years and he didn't say one word about the Quran.
Okay.
And he didn't say he's a prophet.
Okay.
But when Almighty God decide to send his angel and to put his word in his mouth, which is, he's like Moses. I'm gonna tell you why he's not like Jesus and he's like Moses.
Right.
Because Jesus was born without a father. Prophet Muhammad
God
was,
is his father.
Was born with a father.
Okay.
Jesus has a family. Prophet Muhammad has a family. Jesus didn't get married.
Okay.
Didn't have family.
All right.
Prophet Muhammad come with the law. Sharia law, Prophet Moses come with the law of Moses.
Ten commandments.
Similar.
Hold on. Ten commandments. The law of Moses that Moses went upon Mount Sinai to collect from God was the Ten Commandments, right?
Hold on a minute.
I responded to you.
So, is it a Ten Commandments?
I'm confirming.
Right.
It's the Ten Commandments.
Yes.
Plus. The rest, because there is around 613 Moses.
All right.
This ceremonial law for
Israelites.
The Israelites,
right. Okay.
which Jesus come not to destroy or abolish, but he want to keep
fulfill.
Because
the word you are looking is fulfill.
Fulfill.
Okay.
Fulfill, not cancel.
All right.
Fulfill doesn't mean cancel. Do you agree with me?
I agree.
Fulfill.
Not
mean cancel.
Ladies, go ahead.
Do you agree?
I agree.
I don't agree, I'm going to respond. Because I don't agree, I'm going to respond.
Okay.
So, you all heard when I gave him the account, half angel told Muhammad to read, Ikra. He told me my story wasn't correct. I gave him just the correct man. What did he do? He did not do that. So, now, I'm just gonna explain to you Deuteronomy chapter 18,
verse 18. Yep.
Once for all,
right,
okay?
Right,
so,
right.
Brother,
yep.
Read the passage for us.
Deuteronomy
please.
18:18, it says, I will raise them up a prophet from among their brethren, like unto you. Who is that you?
No,
first of all, but we will carry on. And I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him.
Okay.
Can I respond to this?
I haven't said anything for you to respond.
Please.
This is my responding time, Yahya.
Let her respond first.
This
is my responding time.
Have Islamic Dawatim come to the conclusion that Moses is like Muhammad. They went through their family line.
Right.
He had a child. Uh-huh. He was married. He brought law.
You have a father.
He is the one essential thing.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to them, when they need to practice using their brain, they haven't done that.
Right.
A prophet like
unto you.
So let me explain what Bible meant
by you.
And Bible meant what it meant.
Right.
Deuteronomy chapter 34, verse 10 to 12.
Right.
I am gonna read it.
Right.
Since then, no prophet has risen in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face.
Wait a minute.
Whom Lord knew like face to face. Who did all those signs and wonders the Lord sent him to in Egypt, to Pharaoh and to all his officials, and to all his whole land.
Brilliant.
For no one has ever seen, shown the mighty power, performed the awesome deeds that Moses did in the sight of all Israel. Prophet like you meant man who God saw face to face. For Moses, the one who was a murderer, the one who
excellent
accused,
point.
The one who tried to complain to God.
Uh-huh.
Whole heaven came down for Moses. God,
wait a minute, we'll answer
saw,
you in a minute.
God spoke to Moses face to face. God
can
spoke
I help you?
To Moses face to face.
Right.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing.
Uh-huh.
If we are looking something like Moses, let's see. I'm going to compare them for you. Verse tells us, God saw Moses face to face.
One.
Did ever in history, even in Islamic tradition, Allah bothered to speak to Muhammad? I am not even asking.
Right, carry
on. Did Allah ever saw Muhammad face to face? No.
Right.
Allah did not even bother to speak to Muhammad.
Brilliant point. Come on, brilliant.
Did Muhammad do any miracles like Moses?
No.
No. He freaked out when people asked him, oh, Muhammad, if you are prophet, do some signs for us. He freaked out. I can't do anything. People did before me. You did not believe in him. Let me just simply compare Moses versus Jesus.
Yes.
How Deuteronomy 18 proves not only Islam is a false religion, religion, Muhammad is a prophet who should put to death, yet fulfilled by Lord Jesus Christ.
Right.
Here is the thing. By the way, kindly please answer. If it was Moses was like Muhammad, they both had families, wives, brought the laws. Can you just tell me why that passage is not talking about the Caesar, yet it is talking about Muhammad? Mm-hmm. Respond to that when it comes to you. Here is the difference between Jesus, same with the Moses and Jesus. Moses was Israelites.
Brilliant point.
Jesus is Israelites.
Right.
Moses born under the foreign law. Jesus was born under the foreign law.
Next point.
Baby boys were killed at the time of Moses when he was born. Baby boys were killed at the time when Jesus was born.
Brilliant point.
But Moses and Jesus escaped, murdered as a baby. But Moses and Jesus spent early years of their life in Egypt.
Brilliant point. This girl is
Moses
good.
And Jesus left Egypt for what? For Israel. Both of them. Both Moses and Jesus.
Are you giving a lecture? Are you
for,
giving me
hold on. Let me give you an answer.
Is this all answer?
Yeah, do your question.
Moses and Jesus.
Last point.
Moses and Jesus did something very important.
Right.
They saved people
from their sins.
Slavery. Moses saved Israelites while they were slaves in Egypt.
Right.
Yet, Jesus saved us
from our sin.
Slave to sin.
Right. Brilliant point.
Moses and Jesus, both of them came first for the Jews.
Right.
But Moses and Jesus, they fed the hungries in the desert.
Right.
Moses and Jesus cured the leprosy. Moses and Jesus had a power over the sea.
Amen.
Moses and Jesus spoke to God face to face. Moses could celebrate the Passover. Jesus celebrate the Passover.
Brilliant.
Both of them commissioned the successors.
Chosen by God. Chosen by God.
Yeah. Both of them has something in common as well.
A little bit more.
Both of them died. Both of them died. Yet.
Brilliant point.
What is unique with Jesus is he is still alive on the third day. According to scripture, he raised from dead. Yahya, listen this carefully. From now on, when you give us the quotation on John, Deuteronomy chapter 18, remember, Deuteronomy chapter 18 screams out, Muhammad is a false prophet, yet confirms Jesus is the one who is like Moses.
Brilliant.
Fulfilled Deuteronomy chapter 18, spoke to God face to face. He is God incarnate. He
Can
is
I come
the servant
in? What
of
about
God.
My point? I am finished. I'm going to bring you a point because I've got a point to bring out.
Please.
That's my Bible. No, that's all right. That's fine. It's not like a Quran. Let me take out my Quran because according to my Quran, it says...
According to Surah 27.
No. Let me give one. I've got one. According to the Quran, it says Surah 4, 156. Let's read that one. Surah 4, you got your Quran. Surah 4, 156.
You mean 157?
No, 156. We're going to hear it.
For their disbelief and their saying against Mary, a great slander, and their saying, indeed, we have killed the Messiah, son of Mary, the messenger of Allah, and they did not kill him, nor did they crucify him, but was made to resemble him to them. And indeed, those who differ over it are in doubt about it.
Right.
They have no knowledge of it, except the following assumption. They did not kill him for certain. Rather, Allah raised him to himself.
Yeah.
And ever is Allah exalted in might and wise.
Right.
Verse
right?
Allah, who is ruling and reigning up there, is hanging out with Jesus.
Amen.
It is Jesus. He's still alive.
He's still alive.
It's not only anywhere that alive Jesus is. Next to Allah. I don't know, chit-chat, have hot chocolate, play games, 2,000 years.
Don't go that far. Go on, let him come in, let him come in.
What is your point with this?
You can see, she's actually...
No, the verse I was going to give you, I'll give you
God by saying that he's chatting, Allah, he's chatting with the Jesus, having hot chocolate and this stuff. And the Bible...
He's just joking.
I didn't interrupt.
All right, go on, let him carry.
And the Bible teach that Jesus, peace upon him, will be seated on the right hand side of God.
And I'm going to get voted, just wait one second. Yeah, sorry.
She doesn't want to walk. Carry on.
And this is actually that God raising Jesus, peace upon him, and glorifying him by honor him by sitting next to him as I accept. That God, he will glorify all the prophet and messenger and honor them. Second, when we talk about a prophet like you, when God talking to Moses regarding Deuteronomy, 18:18, what the common between Prophet Muhammad and Prophet Moses? Both of them. First, they are coming from brother of the Israelite, because the Ishmaelite is the brother of the same father, Abraham. And when God say send it to you, Jesus peace upon him, he said, I've been sent only to the lost sheep of Israel, and he commanded his apostle to go only for the lost sheep of Israel, not Gentiles or something. So the light of Gentiles, the prophet Muhammad, who come to the Gentiles with the Israeli, as I mentioned in Surah, chapter number 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, God spoke through his prophet to the Israelite from verse number, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 39 to number 112. That means Prophet Muhammad, he coming to speak with the Jew, to speak with the Christian, as well as the second, the third, the chapter 4, which is Surah Al-Ma'idah, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through his prophet Muhammad, talk to the Christian that don't say it's three God, but it's one God. Our God is one God, never break to three baby God. Jesus, peace upon him. No, you cannot respond. Because Jesus, the greatest commandment Jesus teach, the Lord our God is one. And he didn't equal himself to God, because he said, my Father is greater than the Son, greater than all the creation. So Jesus, he equal himself to the creation. He didn't equal himself to the Creator. The Creator, he is above the creation.
Jesus said, I am my Father.
Third point,
tell him that.
If God accept that Jesus died on the cross for the mankind, that mean God is not unjust with the Son, because he's asking for the blood of the Son as tag price for the sin of somebody else. And this is not right.
Why not?
Because God is just. If I commit sin, it wouldn't be just that you go to my son or my father and judge him. You have to judge me. And Jesus didn't teach incarnation. When he teach God is in me and I am in God, when he pray to the believer to be one with him and God, the believer wouldn't become God. They become believer and they become unity and the oneness of God. So they don't become God. We are not God. We are human. We are created.
I didn't finish.
I give you as much
right,
as you want.
Stick on the topic.
No, I'm responding according to you.
Yahya, Don't go to the Islamophobia TV and then read it what you copied from Islamophobia TV. Answer my questions.
Okay, stop. Answer my questions, please. You said that Jesus and Moses, they see God
yeah.
face to face.
Yes,
and we know that in John, God is a spirit, 4:24. John 1:18, no one have ever seen God, but God is the one and only. No one seen God because God is invisible, eternal and immortal. God wouldn't incarnate to die because he's everlasting. God, according to your Bible, is everlasting. If he die even for 1 minute, that means he's not everlasting anymore. That means the death is overtake him. That means the creation will die as the ever living God is dead.
Okay, understand. Okay. We understand.
One more.
Okay, to your conclusion.
I understand what you said.
And Matthew number 6, verse number 6.
Wait.
Jesus teach him
Wait.
That when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father and my
in
Father,
heaven.
My yep. God and your God, my Lord and your Lord, who is unseen. So nobody able to see him. So how come Moses and Jesus seeing God face to face? This is my question to you.
What is the text? What's the text? Text first.
Is there two God? Jesus.
Read the text and then
Jesus
answer.
on earth as God.
Read the text and then
answer. The Father
answer,
and heaven as God.
Okay,
so
all right.
We have two God.
All right. Matthew chapter 6.
So, let me as the brother looks at for he's going to read the Matthew 6.
Let me
just make one essential point. Yahya, sir.
Yes, Hatun.
Why are you so scared of answering my questions and you are changing the topic?
I'm responding
why
to what you said.
Why are you changing the topic and not answering my questions? We established, Deuteronomy 18:18 has only thing to do with Muhammad
yeah.
is the confirmation.
Yes.
Muhammad is a false prophet whom should put to death. If that is your digging, that is absolutely fine.
I ask you the
simple question. Tell me, why, if that is your criteria, Muhammad had a father, Moses had a father, he had a family, Muhammad had a family. They all brought the new laws. Why that person cannot be Caesar? Or why that person cannot be Alexander the Great? If that is your criteria,
Nimrod, or
Nero, or all other kings,
right.
Why not?
Can I answer?
I'll give you time. And next time will be your conclusion statement.
Let him answer this one. Let's hear him.
Let him answer this one.
Go on now.
Moses came with the law of Moses.
What was that law?
From God.
What was the law?
Prophet Muhammad came with the Sharia law, which confirmed.
It's a different law.
Alexander the Great came with the
law. Of course.
Nero came
with the law. Yes.
Caesar.
Where's that law?
Law.
We are talking about the prophet.
Crushes
wait.
Your
Where
arguments.
In the Quran it tells you the Ten Commandments was in the Quran? Show me.
Brother,
show me from the Quran the Ten Commandments. The same law that was given to Moses.
So, I'm going to make my conclusion and then we've done, okay?
Yeah.
So, here's the thing. Guys, listen this and watch this very carefully. When Islamic Dawatim fails to answer the questions, or the passages they bring from the Bible confirms Islam is a false religion. When those passages confirms Quran is a false book, when those passages confirms Muhammad is false prophet, what do? Twist the subject, change the subject. I wonder why. Undefendable Islam, undefendable Muhammad, shame on Islamic Dawatim.
You finished?
No, I'm responding your things.
Okay.
So, here's the thing, Yahya.
I ask you a question.
Because Because you never met a Christian who believes in three gods.
Never.
Because you never met a Christian who believes in two gods.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you read the Bible, Bible never told you Christians believe two gods or three gods.
No.
That doesn't give you right to tell me what I believe.
Right.
Ma'am, are you Muslim, are you Christian?
No, no,
how many gods do you believe? She believes in one God, sir.
One God.
One God.
Wait, one God.
Brother, how many gods do you believe?
One.
How many gods do you believe?
God the Father, God the Son. They will be seated together next side to side. Which one is God?
So,
which one is the one?
My question to you. How many gods do you believe?
How much God
one
you believe?
One God.
Muslims believe one God.
Okay.
Christians believe one God.
And Jesus affirmed one God.
Yet, Islamic Dawatin pretends that
Trinity is one God. Trinity is one God. No, it's not.
My Bible doesn't teach more than one God.
We don't believe in Trinity.
Because the Quran failed once again.
Yes.
Because the Quran failed to understand what Christians believe.
That's it.
Thus confirms Allah, all-loving Allah.
We don't believe in three God, it's one God.
Fail to understand what Christians believe.
You failed to show you from the scripture?
What Christians believe?
You said Allah is rubbish, yeah?
Since Allah doesn't understand what Christians believe, let me educate Allah beside Muslims once for all. None of the Christians believe there is more than one God. Christians believe there is only one God. And our scripture tells us God is one and only.
And
love your
Jesus.
God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, with all your strength. Jesus comes and then confirms that.
Right.
Christians believe there is only one God.
Amen.
God deserves all praises.
That's it.
Christians believe that God, living God, who is everlasting, he was beginning to end, who is identified as Alpha and Omega. Lord of Lords, King of Kings, is Trinitarian God.
Yeah.
Three persons, not three different beings. Amazing.
Okay.
Quran doesn't understand
it. Give him a point.
May I ask you?
No, I haven't finished. I believe Jesus is identified as God, who is the eternal Son of God. You know why? Because
he rose from the dead.
This book, which Quran came to confirm, identified as the Bible, basic informations before leave the earth, tells us Jesus is Yahweh. Jesus tells us, honor the God. Honor me exactly the way you honor God. You worship God, you worship me.
Amen.
You pray God, you pray me. Jesus tells us, I have attributes of God. Jesus tells us, he has the names of God. Alpha and Omega. Ego, Emil. Jesus tells us, because I have the attributes of God, I can do the deeds of God. And that Jesus comes from the throne. He is seated at the right hand of the Father.
All right.
Christians believe Jesus is God because of that, sir.
Right.
So, Yahya, this is your conclusion statement. Make your conclusion statement.
My conclusion statement, that she said Allah is rubbish. She said Allah is rubbish. And if you open any Arabic Bible, open in Genesis 1:31. The word Allah, you will find it mentioned 31 times. According to the Jew, Allah is their God. Allah is the God. Jesus, peace upon him, he worships this Allah.
Show me
Allah
that.
In Hebrew, this is in Hebrew. Allah means, this is mean Allah. This is mean Allah. And this is mean Allah. Allah tells. And Allah is the God of Jesus, whom he fell on his face and served and glorified. Jesus, peace upon him, he never teach that our Lord Allah, he broke to three baby gods, because he said there's no God beside him. In Isaiah, in Isaiah 44, 6, Isaiah 45, 5, Isaiah 46, number 9. He teach that I am God and there's no God beside me.
Hello, we can take your question in a minute.
When he sit on the right hand side of his father, which one is the true God? The mighty one or the Jesus?
Both are God.
No, because God, there's only one God.
No, according to you.
No, according to your Bible.
No, the Bible said God, you want me to show you? God is Father and Son. One family name, God.
Isaiah 46, number 9.
Right.
I am God and there's no other. One God.
Isaiah what?
I am God and there's no one like me.
Right.
Did Jesus look like any of you or not?
No.
Yeah, he does. He eat, drink, he go to toilet.
We are born of human. None, Jesus was born from divine.
Please, Yami, please. None of us is like God, because the Creator is not none like his creation. We are created to worship this God, and he said he's invisible, eternal, and immortal. So God wouldn't become not eternal and wouldn't become mortal, because this is his attribute. And if he changes his attribute, he's no more God. This
can
is
I answer
my,
your question?
This is
Let
my,
me do my conclusion and then, again? No, oh, I'll do the conclusion and then you.
I come back to say as well, in John number 4, number 24, God is a spirit. A spirit is no form for a spirit, no form. Jesus, he have a flesh and bones. He have a form. When he come to the disciple, and the disciple after the resurrection, he told them.
Oh, you believe in the resurrection?
Yeah.
You believe? You believe in the resurrection? Well done. Congratulations. You believe in the resurrection?
Let
me tell you this. I'm going to cut it right here. Listen this. No man that I never know die and come back from the dead. If you say you believe in the resurrection, you believe Jesus is God. Okay. Because he's only God can die and come back again.
Okay.
Argument closed.
Okay.
You can finish now.
God saved Moses from Pharaoh. God saved Noah from the flood. God saved Jonas and from the womb of the whale. Why God wouldn't save Jesus from dying humiliated?
Because he was a sacrifice to the world. He was a sacrifice for the sins of the world.
Can I answer that?
Go on.
Jesus went after the resurrection according to you.
Yeah?
According to you. Well, the first woman he met, Maria Magdalena, which was going early in the morning to look for him.
That's right.
When she met him, she didn't recognize him because he was wearing the gardener.
Yeah.
And she's talking to him and she didn't recognize him. Then he told her, don't touch me.
Yes.
A woman, he said, don't touch me.
Right.
Because I didn't ascend to my father and your father.
That's right.
My God and your God.
That's right.
My Lord and your
that's
Lord.
Right.
Because I didn't ascend to him.
Yeah.
But he told her, go to my brother and tell him I'm coming.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
when
he come to them, what he told them, touch me.
Yeah, yeah.
So he didn't allow the woman to touch him, but he allowed the man.
Right.
But she didn't recognize him because he's wearing the gardener. Because he went...
Divine. He was divine.
No, he's not divine. When he ran out of the Jew.
All right, what's your point?
With the Jew.
All right.
With the soldier, which they didn't know him.
All right.
Because the sign when he come to he need to kiss him to that the soldier recognize that this is Jesus. he came, actually, Judah, who betrayed him, we know from the Bible teach us that he is very similar to Jesus. So they take the wrong man and they crucified him. That's why Jesus, when he fled away and he come back the next day, please, the next day, where after 3 days, where is the gardener? That's why she recognized him. And God and the Gospel of Luke, and when God sent, when Jesus was praying to God, God sent him an angel to assure him that he's gonna save him. Besides, come back to the point.
You know what this means? He's now a Christian.
Wait.
We give for the last 10 minutes. He's talking on the Bible. He's a Christian. Go on, carry on, listen. Brilliant.
One more.
He's now talking Bible.
How is fit? How is fit for God to be circumcised? That means if Jesus peace upon him, a complete God, and he was circumcised, that means he lost something from his body, which is not pure. And besides, you're laughing, but he was circumcised. And
he's telling the Bible story.
Is that fit?
Let's pray for him.
To be circumcised?
Can we pray for him now? He's a Christian now.
I'm not a Christian.
I am a Christian now.
Yeah, here, let me respond. Can you say?
He's not talking all the Bible. Where is the Quran?
Let me conclude.
Finish now.
I'm going to conclude now.
You've been concluding for 10 minutes now. You've been concluding for 10 minutes. You've got 1 minute, okay?
We'll give you a minute to come forward and make
it. You've got 1 minute.
Yeah,
yeah,
conclude.
You've got 1 minute.
I am a Muslim who love Christ, believe in Christ, believe in Allah.
And soon will be baptized, yeah.
Believe in Allah who saved Christ, and I would believe whatever that God is not just as a criminal to send his son to die for somebody else. Uh-huh. Because if God is all just, all forgiving, he don't need God, he don't need blood. He don't need sacrifice.
Right, let him finish, and she's going to come and wind it up. I will let you come in.
Allow me, please.
Yeah?
I believe that this God is all loving, all forgiving, all merciful, all just.
All right.
And he wouldn't accept to take a price, a blood price, to save or to forgive others. He will forgive as long as you come with obedience and pure heart to him. So obey your Bible, obey Jesus who served, obey and teach obedience, glorify the Father, and obey your Lord. And Allah,
and Jesus Christ,
Lord of everything,
and Jesus Christ.
Yeah, you obey Jesus, you obey Allah.
Right.
And I finish. I love Christ. I love Jesus.
Yeah, yeah. You finish. Let me just respond what you said.
And you will soon get baptized.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah. I'm doing my conclusion now.
Conclusion now.
It is amazing. When you come to the conclusion, you just jump from one topic to other topic, and then jump from one tree to other tree, and then come up on lots of things. Here's the thing. I'm just going to respond a couple of things you said. As you stated, Jesus worshipped God. Jesus prayed to God. Therefore, he cannot be God. Mm-hmm. He is the amazing thing.
Yes.
Even the way Jesus prayed, proves Islam is a false religion. Even the way Jesus prayed, proves Muhammad is a false prophet. Even the way Jesus prays, proves Quran is false book. As Jesus prayed, what did he say? Father. According to Islam, Allah is father to no one. You are only slaves of Allah. That's all you are. As Jesus prayed, he called God Father. Convince Muslims, give up that Islam. It is dangerous, and keeps you as a slave. You talked about how you butcher actually Christian scripture. It is amazing to see. You said, since Jesus ago, it was essential to the Jews to get circumcised. Prophets got circumcised. Even the circumcision of Jesus proves Islam is a false religion. Even the circumcision of Jesus proves Muhammad is a false prophet. Even the circumcision of Jesus proves Quran is false book. When did Muhammad got circumcised? I know, you can't remember, because as a prophet who's supposed to be the example to all mankind, something happened. He did not even get circumcised. I wonder why. Yet, circumcision of Jesus proves Jesus God in flesh and proves Muhammad is a false prophet.
Finish.
Anything it is else? Amazing to hear from Muslims.
You want
to
come in now, sir?
As
come here,
they
come
talk here. About the stories from the Bible, they deny the death of Jesus.
All right, sister.
But essentials is this. Jesus did not only die for certain people. He died for you. He died for me. He died for whole world. Why he died? Because you are sinful. Because I am sinful. My sin was the one who made eternal word of God to humble and get on the cross. It was my sin. It was your sin. Amen. Today, as you mock my God, today, as you say you believe in Christ, yet you deny my God and you lie about my God, sir.
Amen.
You got to repent.
I give you Bible
have
reference.
Got to repent.
I give you Bible
right.
reference.
Right.
The reason, it's not only you've got to repent, you must obey the word of God.
Right.
You must obey Lord Jesus Christ, whom will give you eternal life. And it is that Jesus Christ who is going to allow you to stand in front of Holy God, who is just
right.
and who is mercy. My God is not your Santa Claus or your grandfather. My God is identified as Yahweh, whom cared for you, whom concerned for you. Therefore, eternal word of Yahweh came and died on the cross for you.
Right.
And that eternal word of God
okay.
resurrected. He is seated at the right hand of God.
Oh.
And that one is going to judge you.
Right.
And
you
had opportunity. He is going to judge you and he's going to judge you.
I want to ask you a question now. So let's move on.
Can we move on?
Sister, give me a little break. Yeah, give me a little break.
Sister.
All right. No,
I'm done with you.
No, that's it.
I'm done with you.